In order for artificial intelligence to evolve into its next phase, artificial general intelligence, we must examine the capabilities and limitations of biological neurons and how these relate to machine learning. Last time we examined the fundamental architecture underlying machine learning, and in this video we focus on another fundamental issue. It is difficult to represent numerical values in neurons and impractical to represent them with precision.
FutureAI. Technologies that think.
Machine learning algorithms rely on their ability to represent numbers with a high degree of resolution and accuracy. This is difficult or impossible with biological neurons. Moreover, the more accuracy is needed, the slower the neuron-based system will run. Any biological brain implementing the numerical precision required by machine learning would be too slow to be useful. In a computer or in your brain, both transistors and neurons represent information digitally. Transistors by taking one of two defined voltage states, and neurons by emitting spikes. Given such components, there are a number of ways to encode numerical values. First, the frequency of spikes, or bits, in a single serial signal. Second, the timing of spikes in a single signal. Third, some encoding of parallel signals. And fourth, some more complex encoding scheme like binary integers, or floating point, or Unicode. While it is theoretically possible that streams of neural spikes could encode binary numbers or Unicode strings, it is impossibly unlikely. The first three methods, however, do appear in your nervous system, and all of them exist in computers. In the brain, numeric values could be represented by the number of neural spikes in a given time period. But remember that neurons are really slow, with a maximum frequency of about 250 Hz, or 4 milliseconds per spike. If we want to represent the numbers 0 through 10, we could allocate a time period of 40 milliseconds. If 10 spikes occur in that time period, we could say that represented 10, and if no spikes occur, that could represent 0, etc. But there are some issues with this approach. Because you can't have fractional spikes in 40 milliseconds, you can never represent more than 11 distinct values. If you want to represent 100 different values, you'd have to wait 400 milliseconds, nearly half a second, to know what value you've represented. This is much too slow to be useful. In this method, rather than counting the number of spikes in a given time period, we'll examine the timing between adjacent spikes. Many peripheral nerves fire faster with greater stimulation. Some retinal nerves, for example, fire faster with brighter light. Since the fastest firing rate is every 4 milliseconds, we might let that represent 10. Firing every 5 milliseconds might represent 9, 6 represents 8, etc. Now we could represent the same 11 values in 14 milliseconds instead of 40. Neurons are actually very good at this type of differentiation, and neuron pairs can easily detect if a spike timing is at any specific given level. If you wanted to detect 10 different values, you need 20 neurons. You might ask, if 4 milliseconds represents one value, why not let 4.01 milliseconds represent another? That way you could get any desired level of precision. While this is theoretically possible, unfortunately it doesn't work because of that old bugaboo noise. The brain is an electrically noisy environment, and neural spikes might jitter as much as a millisecond. Let's look at the receiving end of such a signal. By adjusting the parameters of a neuron model, it is possible for an individual neuron to respond to any specific firing timing or greater. That means that to differentiate 10 different signal timings, you need 20 neurons. Pairs of neurons, however, can detect which of two incoming signals is firing faster than the other with considerable accuracy. That means that while this type of signal is very useful for relative values, such as detecting a boundary between two levels of brightness, it is difficult to use to detect absolute signal values. A further issue is that while individual brain neurons can detect this type of signal, there is no known way for them to generate such a signal. The only known way for a neuron to generate, for example, a 6-millisecond versus a 7-millisecond pulse gap is for it to receive such an input signal. This makes any brain computation on this type of signal prohibitively complex. Consider a cluster of neurons to represent a signal. The greater the number of firing neurons in the cluster, the higher the value will be. Interestingly, human touch sensitivity uses this mechanism. The harder you press on your fingertip, the greater the number of sensory nerves fire. This has the benefit of representing any number of values in a single 4-millisecond firing time. But the practical limitation is that it uses lots of neurons. The maximum number of values which can be represented by neuron firing is likely around 10. And machine learning algorithms require much more precision than this. Machine learning's underlying concept of gradient descent presumes a continuous gradient surface, and using only 10 unique numeric values makes the gradient descent surface choppy and discontinuous. Further, the more values you need to represent information in the brain, the slower it will run. In the next video in this series, we will discover why neurons can't perform the simplest summation required for machine learning. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to be notified when more videos in this series are available. And for now, watch this interesting video.